Hi, my name is Herman Tamaris. I play in the movie Nightmare. So I play Robbie, which is the main lead's boyfriend. They move into an apartment together and they're starting that next chapter in their life where the love is not just a teenage love. They're about to start a family and they're renovating the apartment. Everything is fine. And then suddenly the main character starts having bad dreams and experiencing, you know, sleep paralysis and huge, like big time nightmares. And since Robbie, the character I play, is super straight and super nice, he's an environmentalist and everything is just down to earth straight, in her dreams, she dreams about him just as a more dominant and almost like a mean character, like a mean person. So in the beginning, she thinks it's fine. She thinks it's like fun and almost like a little bit playful. But then it goes over to being almost to the sense of being too dominant, what's the word for abusive? Yeah, almost like abusive, which is making her a bit uncomfortable in this. But when she wakes up from the dreams, she still have the bruises on her body, which makes her even more confused. Yes. So I'm doing two characters in one movie. One really nice and one really not nice. It's a perfect character to do, man. It's so fun. Instead of just doing one and focusing everything on that one, I could actually switch between two extremely different characters. So that was really fun. I had a lot of time in between to change, and we never shot them up back to back. We always had like a lunch at least, or some days we just shot one and the next day we shot the other. So that was not an issue at all. It was really just fun for me to be able to try to play both sides of the coin. I think when it comes to movies specifically, I think movies is a great way I'm just going to use an example from last night, because we had a screening last night and a young woman walked up to me after the movie and said, I've experienced having sleep paralysis a lot, and this movie is a good portrayal on what sleep paralysis is, so I could potentially show this to my friends to explain to them what sleep paralysis is, which is like one of the biggest home runs for us, because that's exactly what we're trying to do with this. And I think that's one of the big, like, the greatest things about movies, that you can actually portray something and show something in a much more visual way than just telling someone, and visualize a thought and an idea and just generally make it come to life. And I think that's the most fun about it.
Hi, my name is Kjersti Helen Rasmussen, and I'm here at the BFI with Nightmare. Well, it's in the word Nightmare. It's the film about the mythology behind it. In the Nordic region, we have a nightmare demon called the mare. And then I discovered that word, the mare, is also in the English language, nightmare, but also in the French word, cauchemar. And then I started reading up on nightmare demons. And I found that it's every region of the world, every culture has their own nightmare demon describing the same experience in their sleep. And it's basically the experience of sleep paralysis, which is when you're laying in bed and you're paralyzed, but your brain is awake. And you see a shadow, dark shadow in the door. It's always, you can't see the face. It's always like a silhouette. And then it comes towards you and it presses you on your chest and you can't breathe. So it fascinated me that this experience was the same in other regions without them talking to each other. It's like the brain doing the same thing. Then I elaborated a little bit on the nightmare demon. But it's also a film about a young couple that moves into an apartment, their first apartment together, like 25 years old. It's like the next phase of life. And the pressures that are on them, but also the pressures on a young woman, 25. She's like in a limbo. She doesn't know what she wants, really. Career, a family, maybe some more education. She's trying to find herself. And the pressures that, you know, people keep telling her what to do. And then she moves into this apartment and she starts having really intense dreams. And they evolve into nightmares. And then she has to give the fight of her life to come out at the other end. Yeah, casting is really hard, but I was lucky. I had my male cast, which is here with me, Hamon Temeros. He was attached pretty early in the process, and then, yeah. As a director, you know, casting is always a challenge. And again, I think it comes down to timing and luck. But I was very fortunate to have Ailey Harbo. And I think she's just magical. Because I needed an actor with a strong face and a strong presence. And that, you know, you have that kind of face where you can just watch them for hours. Something is going on behind their eyes constantly. And she's one of them. She's brilliant. As a screenwriter, I started, you know, writing those transitions between dream and reality. And I was trying to experiment in how many times can I fool the audience into not realizing that we're in a dream or we are awake. Or yeah. So that was an experiment, writing it. And then we shot it. And I didn't want it to... you know, that the dream was mimicking reality. I needed that. So I needed a cinematography that was similar, but a little bit different. And yeah, we shot it inside in a. We built an apartment, so I wanted that just to be more and more the feeling of dream and confusion, which I think we succeeded with the look of the film, and. Also, the sound design was very important for me. In horror films, in general, sound is very important. But here also, this distinction between dream and reality is also very much apparent in the sound, as well as the images. Even more in the sound, I think, than the imagery. I think storytelling is very important. And I think that's something that we have been doing forever, as long as, like human beings, you know, around the bonfire. But I also, I think it's something that children do by themselves, parents do to their children. I think it's very important for being together, feeling togetherness, sharing stories is one way of doing that. But also the identity that we have and the fascination of hearing stories from other parts of the world and other people that we don't understand. If you hear their stories, you understand them better. So yeah, storytelling is, for me, the most important part of my life. I've been doing it, you know, for so long. But I think people do storytelling in their natural life by themselves from their childhood, really. Then they learn it, you know, from their parents. They always read stories. They always see stories. It's everywhere, really. It's something personal for me too. I've always been like this because I appreciate a good drama, good characters, you know, a good character-driven film or story. But my brain always needs something extra, something more to think about, and that's where the genre come in—the sci-fi, the horror—and. I've never understood why it's been not frowned upon, but you know, it's a genre that has a lot of potential to really bring into them the political aspects of things going on in the world. In a horror, you can do like a huge catharsis feeling. You can see a film and go through something really, really emotionally, and yeah, be scared, and then come out of the cinema and be relieved. But I'm feeling the genre films today is getting more and more appreciation, and our new possibilities are opening for a genre film in general, I feel. But it's true, we do have, you know, genre people, they are very devoted fans. They really, really like the films and enjoy them. I'm so honored to be here, because this is like, you know, it's a horror film. Like a psychological horror film, but still, it's a genre film. So, and this festival is massive. It's so many brilliant films are here. So I think it's really important to include different kinds of films in a festival, like they do here now with the sidebar and different programs. And it's a meeting place for us to come, but it's also a way to screen the film before it's released. often. It's, you know, it's first shown in festivals. So it's a great opportunity for us filmmakers to come and speak to the audience, get the feedback, get some feeling of how the film was going to be received. So it's very important. And I know there's a huge industry part too taking place, you know, pitching and financing and all that. It's important. And the BFI is, yeah, one of the big ones.